Greetings, comrades. Some few days ago, the Zimbabwe government, through the Zimbabwe Reserve Bank, introduced a new currency known as ZiG, which is backed by our minerals in Zimbabwe gold. We partially discussed in the first video this, and we promised that we are going to have an in-depth analysis on what this means. We have since published on 1st May 2024, our latest publication in Vanguard, where there are articles or analysis on the new currency ZiG. If you are in our contact list, you are sure that by now you should have received our Vanguard, and maybe you are yet to read the articles or you are still reading. But if you missed that, you can WhatsApp me on +27833404 for us to send you a copy, or you can write in the comment section. We'll find a way of sending you the latest publication in Vanguard. Now, the governor of the Reserve Bank says that when he launched ZiG, he said that the fuel suppliers in Zimbabwe are not yet compelled to sell fuel in the local currency, that is in ZiG. They are continuing selling fuel in the United States dollar or in rands. But public transport operators are required to charge commuters in the local currency. This means that if I jump into a taxi in Bulawayo, I pay in the local currency ZiG. The minibus owner will now have to go and purchase either rands or the US dollar for them to access fuel, which then it becomes difficult because it will not make economic sense to the operator. So the news that we are reporting currently is that public transport operators are refusing to accept from commuters the local currency, Zimbabwean currency, ZiG. This which then now raises questions on the planning part by the Zimbabwean government. As we are recording this video, you will have noticed news outlets that Zimbabwe is holding an investment conference in South Africa, which is being addressed, amongst others, by the Minister of Finance, Professor Mthuli Ncube. So what we said as the Zimbabwe Communist Party that would support, firstly, that we must have our own currency. Secondly, that will support a currency that is backed by our minerals. That's our position. That's a principal position. But that does not mean we support ZiG. I want to clarify to make a distinction. We must have our own currency. We must have a currency backed by gold. But we will then give a proper analysis in this platform based on what we have published in our publication. But we thought it's necessary that we understand that there was no proper planning in introducing the new currency, to an extent that while government is forcing everyone, including public transport operators, to accept payments in the local currency, but the fuel suppliers do not accept that, and the government is not compelling them to. It wants to negotiate. So that's where the problems are. So we will then, as part of our political education on Sunday, then deal with the question of ZiG. We are still having an outstanding video on hate, which we have not yet finalized. We will try to find space so that we finalize our study on hate and then drawing lessons. Because we are drawing lessons from hate and what it means in this part of the world. Otherwise, have a great weekend. Amandla, comrades.